So you want to get started with augmented reality, but you don't have experience writing code or using 3D design software. Well, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Ryan Kopensky, and today I'm going to show you how to create and share your very own augmented reality experience without writing a single line of code. So let's get started. Okay, so what you'll need for this video is just your iPhone and an app called Reality Composer. Reality Composer is an app built by Apple and it's free to download. When you download the app and you create a new project, the first thing you'll see is a screen saying choose an anchor. In augmented reality, all content has to be attached to an anchor. In this case, you'll see a horizontal anchor, a vertical anchor, an image, a face, and an object. I am creating an AR experience for my friend Ananta. It's her birthday tomorrow and I want to wish her a happy birthday. And so I'm creating a tabletop happy birthday experience. So we're going to select a horizontal anchor in this case. Now, when you tap on horizontal anchor, you see a new scene with some default content. In this case, a cube and some text. We don't need any of the default content, so we're going to delete it. To select an object, just tap on it and then select it again. So tap on it again. And here you see more options. We're going to select delete and we're going to do the same thing with the sample text to just delete it. And so now we have an empty scene. What I want to create is a photo frame with a picture of Ananta and myself and some balloons, a cupcake, and then big text, happy birthday. So that's what we're going to create. So in order to add new items, you're going to select the plus icon, which opens up the content library. This content library allows you to add content that Apple provides to you, or you can import your very own content. So what we're going to look for is a photo frame. As you can see, there's so much content available in this app. And so let's see photo frame. There we go. So there we have our frame. Now we see that the frame is laying flat on our horizontal plane. We want it standing up. What we can do is select our photo frame and we can actually rotate it. Now, what you can see here is you have three cones, green, red, and blue. Those are to move. And then you have circles. Those are to rotate. And so you can essentially move around your scene with one finger, just dragging around, and you can zoom out by pinching with two fingers. In order to see more properties of this frame, what you can do is open up the object inspector using that icon. And now you can see our transform, and there's actually a lot more content that you can see. Now, what we're gonna do first is we're gonna rotate our frame in the x-axis by 90 degrees because we want it standing up. And now if we disable our object inspector, there we go. So now we see that our frame is standing up. We're gonna open up our inspector again and select a different frame style. Now you can see there's many styles. I'm gonna actually move this frame like that. There's many styles that you can select. You have this red frame and you have this two-tone double frame, which I really like, so we're gonna select that one. Now, one issue that you can see is that the photo frame is actually halfway through the floor or the horizontal anchor. We want it to be on top of it. And so to move it, you can just hold the green cone, and as you see, it snaps when it actually hits the grid. And so now our photo frame is properly placed on top of our horizontal anchor. Now, a photo frame is nothing without a picture, and so we're going to add a picture into the frame. To do that, again, open up the object frame, and we're going to look at, oops, it disappeared. We're going to look at choose an image. For some reason, there's a bug in here. You don't see anything. If you scroll up, you'll see imported. Now, we don't have any other pictures here yet, so we're going to import an image. Now, here you see reasons. That's because I've already played around with the app, but what you would likely see is browse. And if you select on browse, you would see your iCloud drive. Now, there is something weird going on here. You cannot use images from your photo library on your phone or iPad. You have to use it from iCloud drive. And so I stored an image in my downloads folder on iCloud drive. And that's how I essentially got the image. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna select it. And then when you select it, you see that it's now part of your content library. I'm gonna tap on that. And now you can actually see that the image is in the photo frame and it looks really pretty. So that's awesome, right? And it was very easy to just, you know, create something awesome already. Now, the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add some balloons to make it a bit more festive. So again, we're gonna tap on the plus icon, and in this case, we're gonna search for the word balloon, because there's a lot of content. And there we go. So now we have a balloon under events. So we're gonna tap it. And there we go. So the balloon is kind of like inside of the frame. So we're gonna move it to the side and move it up just so we can see it properly. Now, this is actually really cool already. And you can see that the lighting is really good on the balloon. But what I wanna do is I wanna change the properties of this balloon. So again, we're gonna open up the object inspector. We're gonna scroll down and we're gonna see style. You have realistic, stylized, and iconic. We're gonna select iconic in this case because I wanna change the color of it. The other two, for some reason, don't allow you to change the color. And so we're gonna leave it white for now, and we're gonna add a few more balloons. So we're gonna tap on our balloon, tap again to have more options, and then we're gonna say duplicate. Oh, that's actually in the right position too. Okay, so that looks pretty good. We're gonna move it a little bit to here. And then we're gonna do one more balloon where we're gonna move that one to the back of the frame. And so again, I'm gonna tap on it. Now, it is a little bit difficult to create this on a phone just because you don't have that much space. And so if you have an iPad, it's so much easier to create on an iPad, but I wanted to show you that, you know, even with just a simple iPhone, you can create a full-blown AR experience that's really fun and simple to use. Okay, so there we go. So there we go. So we have our balloons. I'm just arranging them so they don't look like they're all on the same level. There we go. So now we have three balloons. We're gonna color them now. So the left one, we're gonna color, we're gonna open up our inspector again. And we are going to choose a color for it. I'm gonna choose yellow. That just looks good. Let's look something brighter. And then we're gonna choose the right balloon is gonna be a red color. There we go. That looks awesome. So that's really festive already. What we want to work on next is our text. And so you're going to scroll down to text and enter it. Now you can see it on the floor right there or on the horizontal plane, and you're going to tap on it and again open up the object inspector. So all AR objects can be edited. Oh, there's a glitch here. All AR objects can be edited using the object inspector. And so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna change our text to happy birthday with an exclamation mark. And then we're gonna also, let's see what it looks like first. That actually looks really cool already. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna move it behind the balloons. And if you wanna move the display, what you do is you use two fingers and you drag. So what I'm doing now, that's two fingers and drag. And we're gonna put this higher up and then we're gonna center it. There we go. That's pretty, actually, let's move it a little more. There we go. So that's a little bit small. What we're gonna do is we're actually gonna increase the scale of the text to 300%. And that makes it a lot bigger and a lot easier to read. What I also wanted to do is change the font because this is a little bit too rigid. We're gonna select something fun and something festive. Let's see. So there's a lot of fonts that you can pick from, but I'm going to pick Noteworthy. And then we're going to move this up just a little bit. Again, it's kind of hard to do on an iPhone. This is probably better to do it on a Mac or an iPad. This app is available for every Apple platform. But I just wanted to show that you can actually just use your iPhone to create AR experiences. So now we have our text that is nice and big and it's positioned correctly. The only thing that I want to do next with the text is to give it a different color. And so we're going to select look and we're going to select a light blue text. That looks awesome. And then for the final thing, what we want to add is a small plate and a cupcake because you can't have a birthday without cake. And so we're going to add a new item again and we're going to scroll all the way down to there's a bunch of food here that looks delicious. Okay, there we have. So we have our small plate. What we're gonna do is we're gonna position that in front of our photo album. or photo frame that we have our plate. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna add our cupcake. And so you can see that Apple has a lot of built-in objects, but you can also purchase new objects from online web stores, or you can do it from, or you can make your own. And so it's loading in, and now you see our cupcake. And so moving this onto the plate is a little bit tricky, but take your time. This is actually really great practice for you to just get used to the gestures. And so I am moving this, and you can see that the cupcake is kind of protruding through the plate. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna open up the object inspector and raise it by 0.5 centimeters. Now, it is key to note that this software and most 3D software uses the metric system. And so if you're not familiar with it, it might get some used to, but you know, it's actually pretty easy to learn. So make sure that you do it either in centimeters or meters whenever you're using Reality Composer. And this is our AR experience. This is beautiful, right? And it was very easy to create just on our iPhone without writing a single line of code. Now, before you send this to your friend or family, you wanna test it and make sure it actually works properly. And so what you can do is you can test it in AR mode. So that's what I'm gonna do right now. So I'm gonna select AR and then move around, and there we go, boom, right there. And so the text is beautiful, the balloons are there, it's festive, the cupcakes look delicious. And you can actually see there's like a grid over here. And that's because we're still in editing mode. If you wanna remove that and just see what the other person would see that is receiving this AR experience, you would just press play, and that's it. A beautiful AR experience created on your iPhone without a single line of code. And you can even see the cupcake has like a, you know, like beautiful shine on it, looks delicious. You can even see the shadows of the balloons. It's really awesome. And so I'm gonna stop it and disable the AR mode. And so that's how you share, or that's how you create your AR experience and test it in AR mode. Now, in order to share, what we're gonna do is we're gonna select more options. The more options icon is the icon with the three dots in the top right corner. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna select export. And now you see a context sheet showing up. I'm gonna blur out some of these contexts because they're private, but I will select Ananda. And now we see that the AR experience is exporting. And so it's actually really easy to just send it in a new iMessage like you can see here. The other person on the other side will receive a reality file. That's the format that this AR experience will be in. And they can tap on it, open it up, and they would see exactly what we saw when we were testing it. And so it is very easy to create and share your very own augmented reality experiences without writing any code and just using your iPhone. Now, if you wanted to upload your AR experience to the web for others to see, that actually requires a few more steps. If you'd like to see that, feel free to leave a comment. I'll create a follow-up video. I hope this video was helpful to you. I hope you will start creating your very own AR experiences. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. If this video was helpful to you and you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. And if you'd like to see more videos like these, please subscribe.